back on Friday Night SmackDown. It is Robert Roode one-on-one with Rick Boogs. Rick Boogs been very impressive in the early going in his career here in WWE, not just on the guitar, but in ring.
Yeah, on the ring, or on the guitar, he's obviously been crushing it. But look at what Dolph Ziggler trying to get him. He's still young in there.
And again, the distraction by Dolph allowed Roode to take control. Robert Roode trying to hit Rick Boogs apart here. Remember, Boogs knocked off Dolph Ziggler a couple of weeks ago. Did not sit well with the former champion.
Boogs has impressed everybody in the WWE universe.
Including WWE superstar Toni Storm, who will be in action a little bit later on tonight. She calls Rick Boogs Eddie Van Halen in wrestling boots.
I love that because he is a rock star. I'm not sure Eddie Van Halen could have ate a chop like that from Bob Roode, though. That thing echoed all around Knoxville.
And Boogs now reversal. Roode sent into the corner. Oh, and runs into the double boots to the face. Robert Roode, second row. Oh, a blockbuster by Roode. Cover now, enough for the win on Boogs, who kicks out at two.
Boogs has displayed some of the greatest power we've ever seen in his first couple matches.
Yeah.
Now he's going to get tested by the veteran.
But we haven't seen it in this match yet here tonight, Pat, as King Nakamura, you see him in the left-hand corner of your screen. He's the Intercontinental Champion, looking on.
Oh, okay.
Robert Roode looking for the glorious DDT. Meanwhile, Boogs hoists Roode up on his shoulders.
And he walks him into a Samoan drop. If you follow Rick Boogs on social media, that is no.
What a throw.
On sight. He lifts all the weights you've ever seen in his garage, loses his mind.
Oh, it's one thing to lift weights, Pat. It's another thing to throw around a human being like that.
He throws around dummies as well, but he's been preparing for this for so long. Taking advantage.
Oh, bulldog by Boogs.
The Boogs dog.
Says he wears denim tights because denim represents strength.
And America,
he says. And nonetheless, Rick Boogs setting up Robert Roode here. And Boogs planting Roode. The cover now off the Boogs cruise. And Boogs is cruising.
Blue collar Boogs. Here is your winner, Rick Boogs.
Still undefeated, this guy. Are they coming over again?
Oh, why wouldn't they, Pat? You're their biggest cheerleader.
I'm not a cheerleader. I'm just a fan. And I resemble the rest of the WWE Universe. You're undefeated, guy.
A celebration by Boogs, the Intercontinental Champion, Nakamura tonight. Broadcast by Pat McAfee.
Whoa,
my God.
Get me the hell out of here.
Commander Aziz just blasted Nakamura.
That was... What are they doing?
And now Apollo Crews out here as well, the former Intercontinental Champion, who Nakamura took the title from.
Slammed his crown and then slammed him.
Crews has not forgotten when he lost the gold to Nakamura.
What are you doing?
Oh, Nakamura driven into the announce table.
Whoa.
Devastation from Commander Aziz and Apollo Crews.
From Penthouse to Outhouse, so quick, celebrating a big-time Boogs win. And Commander Aziz, where the hell did they come from?
Is this your king? King Nakamura, you have made a mockery of the Intercontinental Championship, and I am here to demand a rematch.
A lot of anger in those eyes.
Yeah, someone's bitter. Apollo Crews challenging Nakamura to a match so he can hopefully regain his Intercontinental Championship. Again, watch this. The celebration is underway. Aziz from out of nowhere, running through Nakamura. And then driving Boogs into the steps.
And then King Nakamura would eat the commentary table after getting his crown smashed by Apollo Crews, and then boom, off the side of the table.
And then after the ambush, the challenge from Crews to Nakamura for the Intercontinental Championship.
Well,
quite a buzzkill. All hell just broke loose.